Hello children, welcome to Trinity Academy Matric High Secondary School. I am D. Mahalakshmi, your social teacher. In term 3, class 6, unit 4, we are going to see a new topic. South Indian Kingdoms. South Indian Kingdoms. By the early 7th century, synchronizing with the Harsha's region in the north, the far south had come under the control of the Pallava kings of Kanjipuram. Pallava included the dominance of the Chola and the Pandyas. The latter were then emerging as ruling dynasties in their respective river valley regions. The Pallavas. The Pallava kings ruled around the prosperous settlement and important trade center of Kanjipuram. On the southeast coast of India, Kanjipuram was well known to Chinese and Roman merchants. From the flourishing trade center of Kanjipuram, the later Pallavas extended all over the Tamil-speaking regions during the 7th and 8th centuries. The central part of their kingdom, however, was Tondai Mandalam, a large political region comprising northern parts of Tamil Nadu and the adjoining Andhra districts. Pallava architecture can be classified as rocket temples, Mahendra Varman style. Monolithic radhas and sculptural mandabas, Mamallan style. Structural temples, Rajasimha style and Nandivarman style. Mahendra style. The best example of Mahendra Varman style monuments are cave temples at Mandahapattu. Next, Mamalla style. The five radhas, popularly called Panchapandavar radhas, signify five different style of temple architecture. Each radha has been carved out of a single rock, so they are called monolithic. The Great Penance panel is considered to be the world's largest open air base relief. Narasimha Varma II, also known as Rajasimha, constructed structural temples using stone blocks. The best example for the structural temple is Kailasanatha temple at Kanjipuram. This temple was built by using sandstones. Nandivarma style. The last stage of the Pallava architecture is also represented by structural temples built by the later Pallavas. The best example is Vaikunda Perumal temple at Kanjipuram. Society and culture. The Pallavas supported Jainism, Buddhism and the Vedic faith. They were great patrons of music, paintings and literature. Some of the Pallava kings patronized the Alvars and Nayanmars. These exponents of Bhakti sculpt preached a new form of Vaishnavism and Saivism. Pallava art. The Pallava kings had also patronized fine arts. The music inscriptions in Kudumiyan Malai and Thirumayan temples show Pallava's interest in music. The famous musician Rudracharya lived during Mahendra Varma I. The sculptures of this period deposit many images in dancing postures. The Chalukyas. The Chalukyas ruled larger parts of west and center of South India, consisting of Maratha country with Vadapi as their capital. Chalukyas of Badami, Eastern Chalukyas, Western Chalukyas, these Chalukyas held Harsha in the north, the Pallavas in the south, and Kalinga in the east. Aihole inscriptions. It is found at Meghuti Temple in Aihole. Cave temples are found at Ajanta, Ellora, and Nasik. Kaleshwara Temple, Bagali. World Heritage is a small village in Bagalkot district of Karnataka. It has 10 temples. Out of them, 4 were built in northern style, while the rest 6 are in southern style, Dravida. Next, Kailasanatha Temple. Kailasanatha Temple was one of the 30 temples carved out of the hill at Ellora. It was built during the regime of Krishna I. Elephanta is an island near Mumbai. The Portuguese named it as Elephanta after seeing the huge image of an elephant. The Tirumurti Shiva icon is an illustrative of the sculptural beauty portrayed in the cave temple of Elephanta. The Jain Narayana Temple and the Kasi Vishveshwara Temple were built by Rashtraguptas. Leshan Giant Buddha. Baghdad, the greatest city of Islamic Empire of 8th to 10th centuries AD. Next, recap. To know the southern India states that emerged after the fall of the Mauryan Empire. To acquire information of the ruling dynasties such as Pallavas, Chalukyas and Rashtrakutas and their dominance. To understand their contribution to society and culture with reference to literature, art and architecture. To become familiar with the artist and architectural splendor of Mamallapuram Shore Temple, Ellora Monuments and Elephanta Cave Temples. Thank you.